We'll go for everyone's favorite asana, Shavasana. Close your eyes, have a smile in your face. Sthiram Sukham Asanam. Asana is defined always with a beautiful smile. Sthiravagi Sukhavagi Maduvanta Vidhana Asana Dalirat. Whenever we are doing, performing yoga abhyasa, we should have a comfortable and ease in your body with a smile. So we'll do Shavasana with smile now. Close your eyes. Let us concentrate on each and every part of our body and try to relax it, starting from foot to the tip of the head. Now concentrate on your foot, relax it. Ankles, relax it. Knee joints, relax it. Thighs, relax it. Pelvic region, relax it. Abdomen, relax it. Now we'll concentrate on lower back, relax it. Middle back, relax it. Upper back, relax it. Shoulders, relax it. Elbow joints, relax it. Palms, fingers, relax it. Shift your attention towards chest region. Try to relax your breath. Now concentrate on your neck. Relax it. On your face now. All the facial parts, cheeks, chin, lips, relax it. Tongue, relax it. Ears, relax it. Nose, relax it. Eyes, forehead, relax it. Release all the tensions from your mind. Relax your head completely. Now your body under complete rest. To enhance your relaxation, we'll chant Omkara. Take a deep breath. Om. Observe the vibrations of Omkara, relaxing your body and mind. Let us maintain this relaxation, the calmness, the lightness, the positivity throughout the day. Now slowly give some movements on your foot and on your fingers. Join your legs together, hands by the side of your body. Slowly turn towards right side. Raise your right hand up and turn towards right side. Be there for a while. Slowly come up, come to any sitting sthiti. So body is under complete relaxation, mind is really calm. Now it's the time to practice little pranayama. Sit comfortably. Very simple pranayama practice we are doing. The first one is Nadi Shuddhi or Nadi Shodhana Pranayama. This is alternate nostril breathing. So we'll be inhaling from left, releasing on right. Again we'll be from right, then releasing on left. Left to right and right to left with very slow breathing we have to do. Number of time is not important, how many counts we are doing. Just follow your breath, follow your length of your breath and depth of your breath. Okay, so we'll practice together. This Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama helps in balancing 72,000 nadis in our body. There are 72,000 energy channels running in our body. It try to balance all the nadis just by practicing this one single pranayama. If you are not remembering anything, any pranayama or any breathing practice is also fine. Just remember this alternate nostril breathing. This is really helpful, and it is anybody can practice. Any health issues or anybody, starting from kids to the older age, anyone can practice at any time. Okay, we shall practice now. Place your hands in mudra. This is called as Nasika mudra. So your index and middle finger will be closed, ring finger and thumb will be using here. Close your thumb, use your thumb to close your right nostril. Now inhale through left, close both the nostrils. Use your ring finger and close your left nostril. Now release your thumb, open your right nostril, exhale your breath out. Now with the same nostril, with the right nostril, breathe in, breathe out through left. Inhale through left, exhale through right. Inhale through right, exhale through left. Inhale through left, exhale through right. Inhale through right, exhale left. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Slowly release your hands, close your eyes and observe yourself. Close your eyes and observe yourself. Now we'll go for the practice of Bhramari Pranayama. Close your eyes with index finger. Yeah, many know, I think we can use which mudra? Shanmuga mudra. Yes, absolutely true. So we'll go for practice of Shanmuga mudra. Close your face with fingers, ears with thumb. Comfortably place it, don't press too much. Now inhale and while exhaling chant Ma Kara with closed lips. If possible, you can touch your tongue on the upper palates. Slowly inhale. Once again, inhale. Last time. Let the eyes be closed. Release your hands down. Observe the vibrations of Bhramari Pranayama, one of the balancing pranayama. To recharge your body, this pranayama will be helpful. It creates an inner resonance and helps in healing. This can be performed every day by everyone. So let us close today's session by chanting Shanti Mantra. Join your hands together, keep in Namaskara Mudra. Follow me. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Let the eyes be closed with Tubhu Namana. Bend forward and place your head, touch your forehead to Mother Earth. Slowly inhale and come up. Rub your palms, place it on your face, eyes. Slowly release your hands, looking at your palms. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, sir.
The official theme of International Yoga Day has been declared as Yoga for Self and Society. How we have practicing yoga improved your well-being. So the theme carries multifarious significance. So it has well-being of mankind. It aims to promote the physical, mental, emotional, social, and spiritual well-being of human beings through the use of yoga as a tool. This in turn will ensure that they should be healthy and confident and play a leading role in the society. So now managing health is very important. The research on various health conditions affecting mankind, such as lifestyle diseases, psychosomatic diseases, health concern, is planned to be taken up. This will help to manage the overall health issues of human beings. So self-confidence is the next issue. So yoga fosters self-awareness and self-acceptance, which can boost the confidence and self-esteem in human beings, empowering all people and to ensure their goals and aspirations. So women are whole and soul, actually they lead the family. So you have to take care first of your own health, only then you can take care the health of the whole family. So here is wishing you all a very healthy and happy life. Thank you so much for patient listening.
Women's empowerment, it may be health, education, security, finance, emotions. But I would talk about health because I am a medical practitioner. I would say that because according to statistics, what we are seeing is childbirth, death is happening too much nowadays. About 17% according to WHO, every 24 hours we are having 5 deaths due to PPH, postpartum hemorrhage, due to illiteracy, due to childbirth, child marriages or child pregnancies, wherein we are not educated about it because we are not able to reach to the people who have to be educated for this. And the second point is sexual transmitted diseases, and another is because of the incomplete education regarding the contraceptive devices that are being given to the children. Actually, it starts from puberty, 0 to how much you want to put the age to the female, you can put it is puberty or it is middle age or menopause, after menopause. And another thing is nowadays what is alarming statistics we are getting about cervical and breast cancers. We have to educate this team. So I would ask you people all, because yoga is not only doing exercise, but it starts from the brain to the toe. It calms the mind. It is this discovery of yourself. I would say yoga is for self, yoga to the self, and yoga through the self, because it not only commands, it starts from the brain to the toe. Because this is the reason why they have given more, and anemia is one of the main reasons today what is happening. And another thing is suicidal tendencies, hormonal imbalances has been occurred. So yoga can be done in all these regions. So thank you for this, giving me an opportunity.